All right, I'm Jair, and today we're going to check out the new Foo Fighters thing. Anytime the Foos put something out, you know, I'm going to check it out. So I thought today, why not? Let's just do that together. Oh my God. Woo. So I got the Rolling Stone article pulled up. It says, here Foo Fighters' mysterious new death metal headbanger, March of the Insane. New death metal headbanger. I mean, immediately I'm interested. Here's something interesting. So right off the bat, in this little sub headline here, it says, track build to Dream Widow arrives ahead of band's upcoming horror flick, Studio 666. Dream Widow. I know about the flick, 666, stoked about that. But Dream Widow, I've never heard of Dream Widow, so I'm curious, like, is it a Dave Grohl side project? Is it Foo Fighters kind of doing their own Garth Brooks, Chris Gaines thing? Are they, you know, is this Foo Fighters with a different identity going, you know, doing heavier, darker stuff? I know Dave's had a history of doing, you know, all sorts of side projects and other projects. One in particular being pretty heavy by the name of Probot. So if you don't know about Probot, Probot was like this heavy metal side project that Dave put together. I don't know all the ins and outs, but basically, essentially what it is that... So Dave hooked up with a lot of his favorite singers in like punk and metal, and even Jack Black's on that record doing some vocals. And basically he wrote a song for all these vocalists, and then I think he played and wrote the entire backing track for each song on that. And that was pretty heavy. That's had some really heavy stuff on it. There was, you know, like, I'm trying to think what else was on there. Some Lemmy from Motorhead was on there, and just lots of good shit. But anyway, yeah, so Dream Widow. What's Dream Widow? That's my first question. Let's see what they have to say real quick. Dave Grohl got in touch with his demonic side for March of the Insane. Cool, cool. Definitely like a metal song title. A thrashy new death metal song. The fact that they keep you're using the term death metal so generously. Using that term death metal so generously. It's really got me intrigued. Attributed to the fictional band Dream Widow. Fictional band Dream Widow. What does Rolling Stone know that I don't know? The track, which surfaced on the Foo Fighters YouTube page, claims to come from their new, never-released self-titled album. Although the exact musicians who play in Dream Widow are unknown, so we don't know if this is the Foos or not, it's safe to assume Grohl had a hand in the track given his collaborations with members of Celtic Frost, Merciful Fate, Motorhead, and Venom years ago in his Probot project. Okay, that's what I was talking about. Yeah. The track features a breakneck riff that conjures memories of bands like Slayer and Sodom, along with vocals that sound like they're worshiping at Lemmy Kilmister's altar. So yeah, okay, we're hearing some familiar names and some familiar references. I like it so far. Worship the Unholy Spirit, an unusually gravel-throated Grohl likely growls. Likely, so they don't know for sure if it's Dave. But Dave can do a lot with his voice. If you've ever heard his work with, he does the devil's voice on, what is it? that Tenacious D song, like the final, what is it? The Final Showdown or Beelzebub, whatever the fuck it's called. Worship the Unholy Spirit, an unusually gravel-throated Grohl likely growls. Pray to the God of the Dead. the 3.5 minute track even finds time to throw in an old school breakdown and a melodic Kirk Hammett-esque guitar solo. That would be interesting to find out that Kirk had any hand in it. But I could see with a lot of the riffing in Foo Fighters is pretty blues based, and so is Kirk's. So I could see where the parallels could come, whether Kirk was involved or not. Before locking back into a militaristic rhythm. Militaristic. That makes me think thrash for sure. When you say militaristic in terms of metal, maybe I'm thinking Megadeth immediately. Dream Widow figure heavily, pun intended, into the Foo's upcoming horror movie, Studio 666. The premise of the movie is that we move into this house, I have writer's block, I'm totally uninspired, can't come up with anything. I wind up finding this creepy basement, I go into the basement, I find this tape by a band from 25 years ago that recorded there, blah blah blah, and there's a song that if recorded and completed, the house is unleashed. Oh, okay, alright. That's pretty cool. But let's give it a go. Let's head over to the YouTube and let's just spin it and see what it sounds like. Here we go. Dream Widow, March of the Insane. So far, they just have a lyric video out, but let's go. Motorhead, like heavy Motorhead right away, or old Metallica. I think that's Dave. Okay, I think that's definitely Dave on vocals. It definitely sounds, it still sounds like a Foo Fighters song to me. It's like definitely heavier. There's some different takes on things, production-wise and creatively that maybe you wouldn't hear from the Foos. But so far, super dope. Like, you know, we're kind of in a riff-wise, we're in like a heavy Motorhead, old school Metallica kind of place. I like when it kind of switches up the groove there. I don't know if we're in the chorus. I assume we're in the chorus, maybe. I was thinking it was the pre-chorus, maybe at first. But I think we're in the chorus now. Let's back it up a little bit, and we'll just get back into it. Yeah, this riff right here, very Megadeth, or very, well, yeah, it could be, might as well, you could say Megadeth, but I was going to say, yeah, definitely hearing that old school Metallica, a la Motorhead kind of thing. Definitely some Motorhead vibes in that main riff. And then when it does that kind of like breakdown riff, that slower riff in the chorus, I guess it is, I'm definitely just hearing, it sounds like the Foo Fighters, like a heavy Foo Fighters thing. So my guess so far is that this could be useful on the Foos. That's what I'm thinking. I think it's just totally the Foos. But I like it. It's all right. It's not a thing. I don't know. It's not blowing me away. Maybe that's because I'm like overanalyzing right now. But it's fun. Oh, also, let's get back. So, the generous use of death metal. I guess you could say, I mean, it's talking about worshiping Satan. And it's got brutal vocals. So, I guess that's enough for mainstream press to call it death metal. So, we'll ride with that. We can rock with that. It's definitely, I would say, I would kind of just call it maybe thrash more so. Like thrash, like a thrash slash death track, maybe, just because the lyrics, I guess, and the brutal vocals, I guess you could say that. But yeah, it's a cool track. Vocals are, I think there's a lot of layers on all parts of the vocals, like all parts of what I assume is Dave's vocal. A lot of layers going on in the studio. When it slows down, when it gets into this like more chunky riff here, the chuggy, you know, palm muted chuggy thing. It gives me, I'm starting to hear like a little bit, get a little bit of an Exodus vibe. Another great old 80s thrash band. But yes, yeah, so this is like straight up 80s thrash type riffs. And there's nothing really like, it's not the most creative song, but it's fun. And I don't know, I dig it. It's not probably not one I'm going to come back to a lot, but it's definitely one I'm going to come back to a few times. It's hard for me to say, you know, with bands like the Foo Fighters, with bands like Chili Peppers, just these like legends in rock, in from especially like my kind of generation. Anytime they come out with something new, I just feel like I have unrealistic expectations and that I just have to like let things simmer a little bit, like hear it a few times, come back to it a few times, and just then, you know, then kind of see how I feel. And that's what I'll probably have to do with this one. But so far, you know, it's cool. It's got fun, like almost cliche satanic lyrics, but it's fun, whatever. All right. Woo! Okay, let's hear that solo again. So it's definitely not, it said Kirk Hammett-esque in the Rolling Stone article, and it was Kirk Hammett-esque, especially the way it like rocketed in. But it's definitely not Kirk. Definitely don't think that's Kirk, but it's probably just Chris and Dave, I assume. Or just Chris. But I feel like there might have been a switch off part way in there. I'm not sure. Let's just run that again. I like this. Good transition. Woo! So like right there, just like a couple seconds ago, I feel like that could have been a switch in guitar players, but or maybe it's just two takes from like Chris or whatever. Every time this chorus comes back around, it hits harder. I think this song's like, I was already saying like it's just kind of standard, but I think it's a banger. I'm starting to think it's a banger now. I don't know. After the solo and then this chorus just comes back in. Oh man. And I can't believe I thought it was the pre-chorus earlier in the track, because now I'm like, I'm living for this chorus. I'm all about it. I like the lyrics. I've said everything was generic, but I'm totally backstepping now. I'm flip-flopping here. So, I just gotta hear this chorus again. Woo! Yes. Fuck. Woo. Woo. I'm like physically exhausted after that. That was a banger. I don't know, I was so quick to be like, oh, it's just Foo Fighters having fun. But now I'm kind of like, let me hear, like, give me more. Like, it doesn't have any reason to be this good. Like, no, there's no right. Man, that takes me back. And I'm like, you know, like, in my teen years, that was, it was all thrash for me. So this is taking me, like, right back. So maybe it's just hitting me right in the nostalgia. I mean, you guys can tell me in the comments what you think. Banger or whatever. Let me know in the comments. Banger or whatever. And while you're there, hit like and share and all that fun stuff. I don't know if I'll include this. I got to spin this one more time. Fucking Dave Grohl's the shit. The Foos are the shit.